Second verse, what is yoga? Yoga is the union of breath, body and mind. Correct? Yoga is the union of the self with the super self. That means that you have your tiny self, you, and then you have the universe, all the people around you. So that is also a union. Union of you with the people whom you love very much. That is also a union. A union of you and God or the universe. Many people have different ways of engaging in the divine or with the universe. They may not want to call it divine, but they may want to call it universe. Or some, they call it as divine or God. So whatever, in whatever way they want to, that is called yoga also. To be aware of. Now this being united, I don't mean that you become. I mean that you are aware of. It's two, me and the divine, me and God, and I'm aware of that fully, completely. There's no distraction. That's also yoga. To be aware of the divine or to be aware of God in prayer, if there are many thoughts, will it be effective? Will you feel that you are connected? There's so many thoughts. So that's why this Chitta Vritti means the mind, the vrittis are reduced almost to that only one state. The fluctuations are removed and only one state. Isn't that a much more better way to pray rather than having too many thoughts? So, which means that one of the methods before we go into to prayer is to practice yoga, the pranayama, the meditation. Then when the mind has thinned itself, the vrittis have become lesser, then we are able to enjoy the prayer. Which means that we can enjoy almost everything, correct? When the mind is reduced in activity, then we are able to enjoy so much. When you go for an holiday, you're telling your friends, I'm going to go to this place, I'm going to enjoy the sceneries of this place. You go. Now before you go, there's a lot of thoughts in your mind about so many things, work, family, this, that, society, world, economics and all that. Then you go to your holiday. Physically you go, wanting to, but you're also transporting this mind. Other things like that is very noisy. You go to this place, physically everything has changed, mind still thinking about this, that, whatever that was 3000 miles behind you is still there. Come back, need a few days to rest. to rest from the holiday, because mind is so noisy. So the definition of yoga is to reduce the breath. So before you go, do yoga intense practice at home for one whole day, just clear. I'm going to leave everything behind. I'm going to leave the thoughts behind. So go there in that state of clarity. This is yoga. So you see how we can utilize yoga in so many ways. So this year we see how many words are there? Yoga, Chitta, Vritti, Nirodha, is four. Yoga we will look at when we reach the other sutras, but the three more we are going to look. Chitta means mind. The mind which entertains so many processes. The mind is chitta, the processes are vritti. Nirodha means to reduce. So we will need to attempt to thin the layers of thoughts. Thoughts are so thick. Thousands and thousands of thoughts that make the mind thick. We need to thin them. This thinning process, making it slimmer and slimmer and slimmer until almost one or two thoughts, is called Nirodha. Reduce, reduce, reduce. It requires strength. it requires practice, it requires willpower to continuously reduce and reduce and reduce. The source of suffering is the thickness of the mind, right? So many thoughts create suffering. Reduce everything, where is suffering? When you have reduced all thoughts, you don't find the klesha. Klesha means the colored thoughts or perceptions which color everything. Reduce all that, assumptions will reduce. You will reduce all the assumptions, thinking unnecessarily. And many times we have thought that something bad is happening. We have thought about it, but actually you find there is nothing at all outside. It is what we have assumed. We have allowed the vrittis to multiply. The mind needs to reduce the vrittis when it is not necessary. Many times throughout our lives, we have, when we say we, I'm not talking about you, I'm talking about the people in this, maybe us before yoga, that we have had so many thoughts, and most of these thoughts have just consumed so much of energy. If thoughts are energy, and you know it is energy, many are going in the wrong direction, saying that I have to do this, I have to stop that, I have to change the way I take my diet. So many things we are doing right externally, but the thing that we are supposed to do right is actually internally. If we can conserve the energy of the mind by reducing the vrittis, the thought patterns, we can generate so much of inner power. This is the secret of yogis. The key to their mental strength, the phenomenal memory and power and charisma and long life is due to the constant attempt at doing meditation and prayer by reducing the unnecessary thoughts. If ever they want to entertain good thoughts, it would be through the process of maybe chanting the hymns and the verses. When I say yogis, I'm talking about without denomination. Anyone, anybody who is practicing some form of self-development to attain enlightenment are in yoga called yogis. In different languages, they are called different names. In any pathway, when you find them chanting and praying, very consistently praying, it is to reduce the vrittis. The tools have already been given. When you start to pray, it is to reduce the vrittis. That would be the main objective. So there you have the technology of conservation of energy. There we have youthfulness, anti-aging. It is not by taking a lot of watermelon. It is by reducing the consumption of mental energy. The consumption of energy that is produced in the microelectrical impulses that are generated throughout the body by the secretion of chemicals in the body. All this is affected by the many thoughts. When you have many thoughts, and especially if they are negative thoughts, what is going to happen to the chemical secretions in the body is going to be very harmful. But if you have an opportunity and you want to think, bring the vrittis, if it is a beautiful thought, then the chemical secretions in the body are also positive and like a nectar. The concept of amrit comes from here. So I will choose very carefully the quality of thought that comes. Choose wisely quality of thought. Even if it is a negative situation, I choose to respond positively. What is the technique of attaining this yoga's Chitta Vritti Nirodha? Yoga practice. Now when we were practicing asanas just now, did you find that the kleshas or the vrittis were becoming lesser and lesser? The colored thoughts will become lesser and lesser? When we were practicing pranayama, did you experience that the thought patterns becoming lesser and lesser and lesser? And then when we are practicing Kriya, we deliberately created vrittis, but the vrittis were all connected to each other. They were connected into the practice of Kriya. Each one was connected, like the beads on the mala. They are all connected by the thread. So that thread is one vritti and the others are all connected to it. This is direction. But at the end of that 17, 18, 19, 20th Kriya, we are reducing the vrittis to almost none. So it is a direction of creating the vritti in order to reach a non-vritti state. In asanas, we may not be able to develop it, in Kriya, in Pranayama, but in Kriya, we work with the tendency of the mind to overthink. We convert the overthinking faculty into the techniques of Kriya, divert them, convert them into the visualizations and the technique, and then direct them into the Chitta Vritti Nirodha. So one of the best techniques to do when your mind is just thinking with too many thoughts, at that moment when you feel that you have no control over your mind, one of the best practices to do is Kriya. Because Kriya will channel all these thoughts, because it's a dynamic process. As you do with the thoughts, don't stop the thoughts. Just do the Kriya with all the thoughts in the mind. Don't fight with the thoughts. Just do the Kriya, and Kriya will pull the thoughts into a certain directed thoughts of the techniques, and then allow. When you come out, then it has thinned. May not have meditation, because your technique there is to manage. At that moment, whatever was so overwhelming, it's like going into a room and coming out with clarity. So you go into the practice with so many thoughts, don't have to fight with the thoughts, go into it, the vrittis will be reduced and channeled, and then half an hour later, you come out and all the vrittis that were so overwhelming earlier would have thinned. This verse is very important because it is what we need to see and understand when we talk about yoga. Every moment of our life is transformational. Every moment is an opportunity to transform. This is life. That we continuously grow. That every moment is an opportunity to learn and grow, to absorb and evolve. Every moment. Maybe certain moments we feel that we are taking a few steps behind. Even when we take a few steps behind, we think that that is also some learning taking place. And the next moment you jump back, you bounce back. You don't have to remind yourself about this. Just the practice itself will give you that form of clarity and energy, and a beautiful life can be led. We can all live a beautiful life in this world with an understanding and realization of this verse. With this, I conclude. Thank you very much. Namaskar.